Hello, welcome to Story Ocean, the place where you will find fun and entertaining stories. Make sure to like and subscribe for more. And if you have a great story yourself, comment it below, and I might make a video about it. With that all said, enjoy. I woke up, got ready, and took the taxi to work. It was a normal day, nothing too exciting. I got to work. Something was off. I looked at the clock, 10 a.m. I went to the bathroom. When I came back, I looked at the clock again. 9 p.m.? Was I in the bathroom for 11 hours? No. That can't be possible. I was only in there for 5 minutes. How could it be night already? Suddenly something happened. The building slowly started caving in. Tiles fell off the roof and the support pillars fell to the ground. I tried to scream and run away. But I couldn't. I couldn't do anything. I was stuck doing my work, unable to react. Terror swept over me as the whole building crumpled. Wake up. I sat up to see myself in a taxi at my workplace. It was a dream, but how? It felt so real. I walked in the building, but I was on top of it. What was going on? I saw something in the distance, a man. He was floating in the sky, rings of fire surrounded him. I felt something pulling me. Some force pulling me towards the edge of the building, towards him. I tried to keep balance, but it got so strong I fell. I flew towards him, seeing the city morph and distort. Building fell to the ground and new building rose from the rubble. I stopped flying, and fell to the ground. My vision was black, but I could hear a voice. A voice saying, "It's not time yet." I woke up in the streets. I wasn't in my hometown anymore, I was in New York. I stood up, but I didn't want to. A force was pulling me around, toying with me. The floating man appeared again. I did every reality check I knew. I looked at my phone, counted my fingers, everything. This wasn't a dream. The man got closer, I could recognize him. It was Aiden. But who is Aiden? This man, I knew him, but I never met him, I've never seen him in my life. I walked towards him, again, not because I wanted to. "Hey, Aiden, how have you been? I haven't seen you in forever." I said, but these weren't my words, I was forced to talk and to say this. I felt power, control radiating from Aiden. "I'm good. And, who are you?" said Aiden. I could feel, unlike me, Aiden had control. But suddenly, I too had control. I chose what I said. "I don't know you. What's happening? Where am I? Is this a dream?" I screamed. Aiden seemed displeased. The force controlling me picked me up and tossed me. Again, I was flying to the sky. I could see the world breaking apart the further I got from Aiden. I slowly regained my memory. It was all a dream. I hope you enjoyed that story. Make sure to like and subscribe if you have not already. Thanks for watching.